Now, does God want us to go to hell? Does God want you to go to hell? No, right? So the Bible says God loves us. It says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. ¿Quién es Jesús? Who is Jesus? Son of God, Savior, right? What else? Right, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Jesus has many names and many titles. But something very important to understand, si Jesús Dios, en la capital. Busca Dios tu lupa persona, amahan, anad, y Espíritu Santo. 1 Timothy 3:16, the Bible says God was manifest in the flesh. Okay? God became a human approximately 2,000 years ago. And Jesus Christ showed many signs and many wonders to prove that he was the Messiah. Okay? Jesus cast out devils. Jesus raised the dead. Jesus fed multitudes. He walked on water. But the most significant thing that Jesus did, si Jesús, he never sinned. Okay? He never lied. He never murdered. He never stole. The Bible says he did no sin, neither was guile found in his mouth. So Jesus never even said anything bad. He was perfect because he was God. Now, what happened to Jesus? How did Jesus die? You know? And the Bible says on the cross, God the Father hath made him, he hath made Jesus to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. God the Father took the sins, manasala, of the whole world and placed them on Jesus. Okay? Every bad thing I've ever done, every bad thing you've ever done, the sins of the past, present, future, lying, stealing, murder, suicide, every sin was placed on Jesus. And he died on the cross, guilty of our sins. Now let me ask you this. If I died guilty of my sins, do I go to heaven or hell? If I got what I deserve, would I go to heaven or hell? Because of my sins, I would go to hell, right? The Bible says all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone. So we are sinners and we deserve hell. Jesus took our sins. So after he died on the cross, he had to pay for our sins. Si Jesús Naganto sign Carol Tuluka Atlov and Tuluka Yubie, because he had our sins on him. But after 3 days and three nights, Jesus did something that no one else ever did. What happened after 3 days and three nights? Abandusia, right? Showed the nail imprints in his hands from where he had shed his innocent blood. But he resurrected from the dead. He walked on this earth for 40 days and 40 nights. And then Mikaya Salami, right? Iba. But even though Jesus did that, halos tanan paul muatosai and kerno, when they die, okay, almost everyone goes to hell. So I want to keep your attention because I'm going to tell you how to go to heaven 100% sure, no matter what. If you read this verse with me, the Bible says, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. So you're saved from hell through what? Faith, right? Now, notice in this verse there are two ways that you are not saved, okay? Not of yourself, and not of works, all right? So, suka isa patu ang mga buha, all right? Ang patu pasado maawang pasalik na Jesus udili sa iyong pugalingo. Faith is when you place all of your trust in Jesus to go to heaven, okay? But listen, most people, they say they believe in Jesus with their mouth, but with their heart, kasing-kasing, they trust in their works to go to heaven. Dili ka na ang kaluwasan. Alright? Ang kaluwasan, dili pinaagi sa pagpamiyembro sa simbahan. Ang kaluwasan, dili pinaagi sa pagbuhat, umaayong binuhatan. Ang kaluwasan, dili pinaagi sa pagtutulong. cosas antiguas que nos pagamos a Mosala, not by baptism, not by living a good life, not by repenting of your sins, but by faith is how you go to heaven. Do you know John 3:16? Right. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. There's only one requirement to go to heaven, okay? Not go to my church, not go to your church, not get baptized, not live a good life, not stop sinning, not keep the commandments, but whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Can I stop there? Right. And this is the good news of the gospel. The moment you believe in Jesus, the moment you trust in Jesus, Jesus saves your soul, kabad, forever. And I'm kina buhin dayon walay katupusa. Susabihan ka luwas ka, luwas na kasahan tutungo si Jesus, nagbayad sa tanan. Jesus made one sacrifice for sins forever. He took care of all of your past sins, your present sins, and even your future sins. The blood of Jesus Christ cleanseth us from all sin. So once you believe in Jesus, you can never go to hell. You can never lose your salvation, because when you place your faith in him, he separates your sins as far as the east is from the west, okay? Now, God does not want you to do bad things, okay? I'm not saying to do bad things, because if you're saved, if you're a child of God, and you do bad things, God's going to punish you in this life. Have you ever heard the term born again? Born again? Right. Who knows what that means? You know what that means? Right. Like, some people think it means you're physically born again. Some people think it means baptism. But being born again is whenever you're born spiritually into God's family by placing your faith in Jesus. The Bible says, for ye are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. When you believe in Jesus, you become a child of God spiritually, okay? Now, physically speaking, I'm a child of my parents. And growing up, I did not always obey them. I beat up my little brother. I told my parents I hated them before. I ran away from home before. And my parents punished me, okay? But I was always their son, no matter what. It's the same way with Jesus. Once you believe, once you're born again, you become a child of God, and he will always be your heavenly father. But if you do bad things, he will punish you, okay? If you murder someone, maprizo, probably, right? If you're saved and you do drugs, God might send Duterte after you, right? If you're saved and you drink alcohol and you're going to do stupid stuff, you might cheat on your husband or your wife, or you might abuse somebody. You can ruin your life by sin, but you can never ruin your salvation, because salvation is not of yourself. It's not based off of what you do. It's based off of your faith in what Jesus did. Susadihan na luwas ka, luwas na kasahan tutungo si Jesus, nagbayad sa tanan. Now, is God a liar? No, right? I can lie, you can lie, a pastor can lie, a priest can lie, a church can lie. But God is not a man that he should lie. This is a promise from God. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know. Notice this word, know, that ye have eternal life. If you believe in Jesus, you were only Jesus. Right? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. You see, Buddha, Allah, Muhammad, Kibaloi, you know, whoever, none of them went to hell for your sins. Only Jesus paid for your sins. Is that fair? Right? And once you believe in Jesus, how long does he save you for? Temporario, buhantu, sahantu. Right? So let me quiz you. What if you believe in Jesus and you never go to church? Would you go to hell or heaven? Heaven, right? Because what? For by grace are ye saved through going to church. Is that what it says? For by grace are ye saved through faith, right? So what if you believe in Jesus and you never get baptized? You go to hell or heaven? What do you think? Right, heaven. For by grace are you saved through baptism? Is that it? No, right? Now, baptism pictures the gospel, but baptism is not the gospel. Okay? Listen, call me now. Paul the Apostle said, Christ sent me not to preach, not to baptize, but to preach the gospel. So baptism is not the gospel. The gospel is believing the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. You believe this? Alright. So let's take it up a notch. What if you believe in Jesus and you murdered someone, God forbid, and then you never repented of your sins, but you believed in Jesus and you got saved? Would you go to hell or heaven? You would go to heaven, right? And I'm not getting a lot of answers, but this is important. If you're trusting in your works, you're going to go to hell forever. Okay, not a joke. That's why I'm here. That's why we're here. I want you to go to heaven. But if you're trusting in your works, you're trusting in yourself, and you're going to go to hell. Okay? But what if you believe in Jesus, and then you even committed suicide? But you believed in Jesus, and you got saved forever. Would you go to hell or heaven? What do you think? Well, for by grace are ye saved through what? Faith. Is it by keeping the commandments or faith? Faith, right? So if you believed in Jesus, and God forbid, you even got so depressed that you committed suicide, you would go to heaven, okay? And listen, people lie to you about this. I'm a Baptist, but most Baptists, hey, can you be quiet, please? Most Baptists, they teach you can lose your salvation if you commit suicide. Every Catholic teaches that. Almost every religion teaches you'll go to hell if you commit suicide. But that is not true. For by grace are ye saved through faith. If you had faith in Jesus, you would immediately lift up your eyes in heaven. Because two people in the Bible committed suicide, and they did go to heaven. Okay? Do you know who King Saul is? King Saul? King Saul? Okay, the king before David? Do you know him? Right. He took a sword and he killed himself and he went to heaven. And I don't want you to do that, okay? God forbid you did that. But I'm just giving you an extreme scenario. Sabihan na duaska, duas na kasahantu chugo si Jesus nagayad satanan. Nasapan? Alright. Last hard question. What if you believe in Jesus? What if you get saved forever today? And then nagduha-duha. Then you doubt. You stop believing. But you already believed. You already got born again. Would you go to hell or heaven? You go to heaven. Because Ankaluwasan, walai process. Okay? Ankaluwasan, when you believe in Jesus, he gives you eternal life. Not your physical body, but your soul. The moment you believe in Jesus, you have passed from death unto life. You will never go to hell. You will never lose your salvation. But that's what you have to believe to be saved. Once again, this is what I'm trying to persuade you. Because most of you, you believe in Jesus, right? You believe in Jesus?
Yes.
Right. But you also believe in good works to go to heaven. understand the bad news. Walay Jesus, kita agayan may impierno kakita nakasala. Without Jesus, we are sinners that deserve hell. Nasapta? Do you understand that? Right. Do you believe Jesus is God? Do you believe he died for some of your sins or all of your sins? Right. Do you believe he rose from the dead after 3 days and three nights? Right. Now, if you believe this, if you want to make the decision to believe this, how would you tell God you believe? The Bible says, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Do you have a cell phone number? Do you have a landline? Facebook Messenger? Pagampo, right? So, if you pray to Jesus and you ask him to save you, do you believe that he would save you?
Yes.
Amen. Right? That's good news. Right. If you believe this, you can go to heaven, right? You can know you're going to heaven right now. I'm going to say a prayer to Jesus. And if you believe this, you can repeat after me. All right? And we will ask Jesus to save you right now, and he will do it. And it's not magic words that I say. It's not a magic feeling that you feel inside. Okay? It's just what you believe. If you repeat after me, we'll ask Jesus to save you right now. Okay? You want to do that? All right. Dear Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I know I deserve hell. But I believe you died for my sins and rose from the dead. Please save my soul forever. Amen. Did you believe that? What? Right. So where will you go when you die? For sure. Because Jesus just gave you what? So you're going to heaven for sure if you believe that. A lot of you just repeated the prayer. Okay, I know that. You have to believe what you pray. But if you believe that, you know you're going to heaven. You know you're saved. Amen? Alright. Now, Nana, Papa, Mukana, any questions? Alright. I'm going to leave some information on the board really quick here. If you have questions later. Someone pronounced it Siamese once.
Siamese.